the game could see the boxing boys.
Come on, baby!
Man, it's everything, you know. At the end of the day, I feel like opening doors for the vibe and other people that, you know, all the guys that are not the ones that want things to be us. I'm the one that no one had their eyes on and kind of see that we can get here. And for me to be here today, we need to try shaping the world. And it lets you know that anything's possible, no matter where you're from.
Because when you fought Frank Lars on the show, about you were actually the B-side. Which is crazy to think now, looking back.
Yeah, man, because, you know, these camera women in my face like this, as, like, you know, coming in as an underdog like I did today. But, you know, that time division, man, I channel it, and I go out there and get it.
Was the fight more difficult or easier, or just exactly what you expected?
It was kind of exactly what I expected. You know, in the very beginning, I knew when we poked out his questions, touch me a little bit, because he's a decorated amateur. You know, I'm still learning. And but I knew just keep the pressure. And I saw his face change round by round.
Swift, did you feel him getting tired in the second half of the fight?
Yeah, I definitely felt him get tired. And I knew he would get tired because he started to engage. You know, you never really see long engage. You usually use the ring all so well. But he started sitting there a little bit, standing toe to toe. He even felt like he was behind a little bit with his legs.
What adjustments did you have to make to the fight?
You know, in the beginning, I was kind of feeling him out. He was pop shot me a little bit off of me. And I said, man, I can't wait on him. I got to get in there. And, you know, I can't match tomorrow's skill for skill. I can't stay in the face.
Did Sean say anything to you in the ring afterwards? Because obviously that's the goal. Which you should have done to respect that.
I'm not gonna say anything to him, you know, and at the end of the day, we all know that I'm not running for anything. I feel like Law was my toughest fight. Charlo doesn't even have to, you know, come looking for
him. So that's the fight you want this fight?
That's the fight I want. I want that fight. I want to fight the Miguel Brooks. I want to fight, you know, it doesn't matter. You know, we're both with my team. The bitch isn't right for Charlo, we're fighting next. Not for my team.
What's the most difficult part of Lara's style?
I would say it's a nice straight left hand. You know, it was times he gets over 1-2 and then that left, and he caught me pretty solid a couple times.
Did you work on the uppercut during training camp a lot? Because it seemed like you were catching him just about every round with the uppercut on the inside.
All the time, man. That's my favorite shot. You know, at the end of my career, throwing it a lot, kind of got away from me. You know, we got to look for it. But, right up close, we're going to try to go.
Yeah, not just fighting, but even if I, you know, the talent of Lara, how much better can you come from this?
I'm number one, man. I'm the best in the world right now. So, at the end of the day, we'll go home and watch the tape and see the things we can work on. We knew the fight wasn't going to be ugly, but we touched a little bit.
Against the crafty guy like Edison Lacatada, it was actually a really clean fight, like with the referee.
And referee did an excellent job, man. He let him push aside. I was afraid that every time we got to his legs, you know, Law was going to grab me and get a corner break. Now we can work beside Jimmy Bader. He did an amazing job. And, you know, even with Law sometimes, we didn't know how to do it. He allowed the body shots. He didn't allow Law to complain about it. He did an amazing job. He got his fight. He put it too much into the action. Yeah, I love it.
Do you feel like he's going to put you on a star path? You know, have to go as well, obviously, have the style?
Yes, man. You know, fans love my style. Fans love when I go out there. You know, I feel like this is like a show.
What kind of fight do you think it would be to Charlo if it happens in October? Is it even more competing than this or not as
much? It's going to be much easier than this. You know, Charlo is the type of guy I go out there and I show what's with your talents. And, you know, with some of the guys I've been fighting lately, I had to fight in the Russian type way. I'm usually a counterfeiter and fight on my back foot. I'm sharper than people today. I'm not going to have to do this.
What'd you make of the way Lara fight? It seemed that he was engaging a little bit more than he usually does in prior fights.
Yeah, that's why I say I was surprised he did stay there so he was going to face pending. He thought he was running all the time trying to move up. But I don't know if it was my pressure before now, because you know he felt like he had to kind of stand there, so let me know he's right there with me. I'm not sure what it was.
And when you hear
the voice of the people, the boxing voice. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon to get notified anytime one of our videos drops. Ain't no other sight in the game can see the boxing voice.